So the Glenmore plant was actually commissioned in early 1933, and it kind of outran its life expectancy by the early 1970s, where we had to build the Bearspaw plant. And then the Bearspaw plant was then later expanded again in the early 1980s. So really, the Glenmore Water Treatment Plant could only sustain the city up to the early 1970s. But today, of course, with the current situation that we're in, we're trying to provide water for the city primarily from this plant, which is much smaller than the Bearspaw plant. Well, right now, this plant is working at full capacity. So that means we don't have an opportunity to cool down pumps and motors, don't have an opportunity to do maintenance activities. So right now, our plant is extremely strained and it is not designed to run this way.
Some of the failures that we've seen recently at the Glenmore facility is our pre-treatment train, which is a critical piece of our infrastructure here at Glenmore. What ends up happening when we lose that piece of infrastructure is it brings down our capacity of this plant down roughly 25% of its total capacity.
So we're in one of our control rooms here that's manned 365 days a year, 24 hours a day. Our operators here look at tens of thousands of electronic signals and look at not only things that impact water quality, but also how we move water around the system and store that water in communities around the city. Here is our water use patterns just over the last day. And you know, we talk about people using 450 million liters a day or 485 million liters a day, but that's an average over the entire day. What we see here on the screen, this blue line actually shows what the instantaneous demand is. And you can see at times we're over 650 million liters a day. And then it drops off, of course, at night and increases again early in the morning. So evening demands and morning demands are when are the peak times of day for water use. And then at night is the only opportunity we have in some cases to recover that distribution storage. Well, we did some very creative modifications in our distribution system. So we have a very complex system where we have over 40 pump stations in the system, over 20 underground reservoirs where we store our treated drinking water. And we have to move water very creatively to try reach certain parts of the city. So in doing so, we've actually removed pumps, reverse the flow through some pump stations to essentially shortcut parts of the city to see if we can move water more effectively. So we've gone from being able to manage a 450 million liter a day demand to about a 485 million liter a day demand.
So the teams here have done an incredible job of finding roughly 35 million liters through the use of bypasses throughout the distribution system. Those bypasses have been installed in various pump stations around the city that allow water to, again, flow backwards into a zone that then we can move water into a different area. It is critical that everyone reduces their water consumption to help create capacity at the Glenmore facility as well as the Bearspaw facility and support the distribution system so that these facilities have the ability to have maintenance done on them. And in the event that these failures occur, we have time to respond appropriately.